Hello, welcome to a new video tutorial on heterologous robust chain expression. We know that in biotechnology and genetic engineering, we have two main terminology. One is called homologous gene expression and second one is called heterologous gene expression. Homologous gene expression means it is the expression of a particular gene within the cell where it was. That is, expression of a particular gene within its natural environment or within itself. Whereas heterologous gene expression means if a gene is expressing within the cell which is a foreign cell. So it is not a natural environment. If a cell is expressing outside itself, then such type of gene expression is called heterogeneous gene expression. In biotechnology, we are creating genetically modified organism by inserting a foreign gene into a foreign cell. So if a gene is expressing within the foreign cell, then that gene expression is called heterologous gene expression. So now the definition of this heterologous gene expression is over. Now let us try to understand what is the application or what is the significance of heterologous gene expression? Why we are doing like that? Why we need to transfer a foreign gene into the another cell and after that we are forcing that foreign gene to express inside that foreign cell? Why? For what purpose we are doing heterologous gene expression? So its answer is an elaborate answer because the aim of this heterologous gene expression will be diverse. They have a lot of the aim and objectives of heterologous gene expression will be an elaborate answer. So let us try to understand few aims of heterologous gene expression. So one application or aim of heterologous gene expression is, suppose if we need to produce more amount of protein from a gene, so it is better to culture, so it is better to depend any microscopic organism like E. coli, yeast for producing commercial scale of protein. So for that purpose, we can transfer a particular gene into yeast or a particular gene into E. coli. Therefore, we can able to synthesize more amount of protein by using less expense. So the main aim of this. Second one, if I want to study post-translational modification of a prokaryotic protein. Normally, prokaryotic protein never perform post-translational modification. Suppose I want to know what will happen if post-translation happens in the prokaryotic protein. So for that purpose, I can able to transfer a prokaryotic gene into a eukaryotic cell. So during that condition, that eukaryotic cell perform post-translational modification. So that is second aim. Like that, we have lot and lot of aim and objective for performing eukaryotic gene, for performing heterologous gene expression. So in simple terms, we can say that for research purpose, for economic benefit, for producing various kinds of protein and enzyme for commercial scale, in commercial scale, like that, we have lot and lot of aims and objective for heterologous gene expression. Now let us move into what are the major steps of heterologous gene expression. So what are the two major steps we need to follow while expressing a gene outside the cell? So if I am going to express an eukaryotic gene within the E. coli, then that E. coli cell is called expression system. So expression system indicates that a cell which acts as the place of gene expression, then that cell is called expression system. So let us move into the what are the major steps that we follow while expressing a gene within the foreign cell. So first of all, we have to transfer a foreign gene or foreign DNA into a foreign cell or host cell. That host cell is called expression system. So that transfer of foreign DNA into the host cell or expression system involves three subphases. One is called identification and isolation of DNA, which is going to be transferred into the host cell. And second one, we have to identify, we have to depend a vector DNA for transferring this DNA into the host cell. For that, we have to identify a vector DNA. And also, after identifying that vector DNA, we have to ligate that isolated DNA into a vector. Then we will get a recombinant DNA. So, second step is vector identification to transfer this DNA into the host cell. And after that, the identified vector DNA should modify into a recombinant DNA by inserting this DNA. And after that, identification at a suitable expression system. So, first of all, we need to identify a particular DNA to be transferred. And second one, we have to identify vector DNA. And we have to modify the vector DNA by inserting this identified DNA. So, that is called construction of recombinant DNA. Third one, we have to select a suitable foreign cell or expression system. That is the third step. So, these three steps comes under foreign DNA transfer into the host cell. And second one, after the transfer of foreign DNA into the host cell, we have to understand what are all the different factors which affect the expression of this foreign DNA inside the host cell or expression system. So, second step is that we have to identify, we have to understand what are the factors which affect the expression of this inserted foreign DNA inside the expression system or host cell. So, the second topic is a big topic because the factors that affect gene expression will be of various kinds. For example, we have to identify what are the initiation factor of transcription, what are the elongation factor of transcription, what are the termination factor of transcription, like that, what are the initiation factor of translation, elongation factor of translation, termination factor of translation. All these factors will affect the expression of this introduced DNA in the host cell. So, before conducting all these processes, we have to understand what are all the initiation factor, elongation factor and termination factor of transcription and translation which affect the expression of this newly inserted foreign DNA. So, this is the two major steps which we have to follow while doing heterologous gene expression. And when we move into the examples for heterologous gene expression, we can broadly classify heterogeneous gene expression into two major categories based on their expression system or based on their host cell. To which cell we are going to transfer, or to which cell we are selected for expressing the foreign gene. So, based on the expression system, we can classify heterologous gene expression into two. One is called prokaryotic expression system and second one is called eukaryotic expression system. Prokaryotic expression system indicate that here the site of gene expression is a prokaryotic cell. And like that, eukaryotic expression system indicates that the site of gene expression is a eukaryotic cell. Let us take an example. Commonly used eukaryotic expression systems are yeast cell, because yeast is a unicellular fungi, belongs to the ascomycetes. So, if we select eukaryotic cell, that is yeast cell, as an expression system, it will be most suitable because yeast cell can able to multiply rapidly within a short duration time by using budding, binary fission, etc. Because cell cycle duration of yeast is only 90 minutes, so the division capacity is faster. That is why we are selecting yeast cell as a candidate for eukaryotic expression system. Like that, we can also depend insect cell, mammalian cell, etc. Like that, when we take prokaryotic cell, the commonly used prokaryotic expression system is an E. coli bacteria, because we know E. coli bacteria cell cycle duration is just 20 minutes, it can able to multiply very fastly. In biology, we are taking lot of eukaryote expression system and prokaryote expression system. Here I will explain only in a first type, E. coli and yeast. This is the broad concept regarding heterologous gene expression. Okay.